When Palazzo left Team No Sleep in 2015, fans got very worried. But the dancehall musician seems to have hit the ground running. Of course, beef between the musician and his former manager, TNS boss Jeff Chiwanuka, has been whispered about in corridors, and now the battle lines have been drawn. Palazzo has released a new track called Bagwamu, in which he claims that Team No Sleep has lost it following his departure and that Jeff is a thief. I mean, when you see artists like Palazzo, Palazzo, if you notice, tries his best to stay out of, drama by the time he's releasing a diss song, which is better than going out and abusing the person on social media or verbally, you know, using trick words, you know, attacking Team No Sleep, using his song and everything. And also using his song to pass on a message. I think it's clever. But I can't wait to see what Jeff is going to say about this.
So who is he dissing this
Jeff?
Time? Jeff.
I feel, the manager of Team No Sleep.
Jeff is past that level. And I'm thinking Palazzo is also wasting time. I mean, this guy never backs back, never hits back to them. And he's living his life. I mean, look at his products like Shiba. I mean, his works are evident.
Okay.
So why would you even go ahead and start dissing? I thought this whole drama ended.
This is the thing, Kabs, yeah? When you think about it, if someone is dissing you, it's fine. You go diss me. But when you're trying to touch my money, when you're hindering my progress, when you're trying to take me back, yet I'm trying to go forward, there we have a problem.
Who is doing it to the other?
Jeff is... trying. Team No Sleep is, he alleges that Team No Sleep is trying to say that he, because after he left and started TGM, you know, Team Good Music, that he's not doing as well, that he's lagging behind. Well, Palazzo is trying to show you, no, that's not the situation. This is the situation and this is how it is. Actually, you guys are not doing as well as you were when I was still with you.
Okay, what's your opinion, Malaika? Do you think he's doing well when he's sold us right now, or when he's owning his own label, or he was doing
I think he's going faster.
Oh, so he has no hindrances whatsoever.
I'm not saying he has no hindrances. I'm just saying what I see. I feel like Palazzo has released more music. He has done very many things in a short amount of time.
Releasing music is different from releasing relevant music.
Yeah, he is releasing. I think it's good music.
28 songs in a year and they're not anywhere.
I like his music. I actually listen to it. I like it and I think it's good. It's not number one.
Okay.
Yeah. Like his brother Chameleon. But I appreciate it. I see where he's going to go. He has a long way to go because some of the musicians here in Uganda have been here for a longer time than him. So he's just lucky he's from the Mayanja family.
I like the way he rocks the rhymes when he's doing
his he does his thing.
And an accent as though, oh my God.
Let's check it.
Palazzo, now you know Malaika is your number one fan.
But Nnyanzi, he's married. Let's not cause trouble here. Speaking of which, married Palazzo, what were you doing kissing another person? We'll catch that story next time.
Absolutely. Now, on to the next one. Is married Uswata soon coming back home?
The day Ugandan television gossip queen Mary Lou Swata announced that she was not coming back to our screens and was relocating to London, fans cried at the loss and Ugandan celebrities rejoiced at the news. Well, as Mary enjoys the sights and scenes of England, she has let on that she will be back home soon. So brace yourselves. Mary is coming home.
Well, the queen of gossip, Malaika, are there any hopes?
Mary might be coming back home. I see so many musicians and celebrities right now crying. I am so sorry, but Mary is coming back. Mary, come back home. Lucy, we can't wait for you to come back home. I know some people were absolutely excited for hearing that news, but you know how these guys are. They tease you and they say they are coming, then they don't come.
Let's see if she'll be. What has she gone to do that she has failed to accomplish that she's returning?
It's not about failure. She was going to. She went to London. She was with her fiance.
Okay.
You know.
So they're done with the cuddling.
It was the early stage of their relationship. I bet they needed more time to be together. So, come back home. I mean, they're both Ugandan, so they can all both live here. Yeah, come. One more Mary, come back home. And then when you come back home to Yambe, come back to urban television, we know so many stations that are doing a bit of fishing. Yes, they're doing a scoop on scoop. Speaking of a scoop on scoop, now that we have television stations doing a little bit of a shuffle within themselves and picking from outside and everything, there's been a bit of change in the evening programming. So we want to find out who the king of 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. television is. Who?
Monday to Friday, 5 to 7 p.m. on English television is one of the highest competitions we have. And now with the recent announcement of MC Katz moving to Kamocha-based TV station and taking up a 5 p.m. slot, the plot thickens. Siobhan of Skizzy, Douglas Runga of The Beat, and now MC Katz, who will take the throne as the king of 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. on television.
We have King... Yani, King Siobhan. I'm kidding, Mama. We have Malcolm from Urban Television. Then we have Douglas Runga from the Serena Bits television station. And then we have MC Katz now from a Kamocha-based television station. Mm-hmm. King of 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Let's analyze them. As we've already done it, yes, we've already seen a little bit about them. But who would you vote for? Who would you put your money behind?
Apparently, I'm thinking... They're all doing their shows are in the same docket. However, the presentation differs the way they deliver.
Yes, they're all very different.
Yes, and I'm thinking Siobhan is a little bit more
to your taste.
Yes, to my taste.
Why?
Because he communicates to the urban crowd
as well as urban TV.
For urban TV, not only for urban TV, but the entire urban crowd, whether you're a fan of urban TV or not, but he communicates to that crowd.
Mm.
And when we get to Douglas Runga, he's becoming so comfortable where he is now, and I think it's a little bit too dangerous.
Mm.
Yeah, he's becoming too comfortable, and kudos to Katz for switching. You know, if you're in media, it's about money. They're giving you money, you go make it.
It's not even about money only, it's about growth. Well, for me, my analysis is very simple. Who looks better for me on TV? Well, let's see. Siobhan is... it's like that macho guy, he has so much muscle, so he can carry me. So he can carry me around. Then, Luanga, I want to raid his closet. He has really cool outfits and sneakers. I want to raid them. I can't. I really have to. Then MC Katz, because I've seen him since I was a kid. Like, you know, people you look up to and everything.
Pardon me. Did you say this when you were a kid?
Yeah, he was a kid as well.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Come on. You know he's been on TV for a
very... You fall in the same age bracket?
You don't worry. I was a kid. He was a kid.
Okay,
we were all kids. He started working on TV when we were very young.
Yeah.
He's older than me, yes. But still, it doesn't matter. This is someone I look up to and I'm like, wow, this guy has persevered, broken whatever his barriers, and pushed and pushed and pushed. And he's been, you know, this is not... The Serena-based television wasn't his first TV station,
right.
You know?
Yeah.
So I look to him and I'm like, you know what? This guy is focused.
And where
he's a hard worker. He's a hard worker.
Television, I think he had outgrown that show. He deserved something better.
So just
than
growth,
that.
Yeah? So something just growth, and which is what he's doing now. So we wish you all the best, MC Katz, in all your endeavors and what you're doing.
Yeah.
Douglas Runga, keep pushing.
Keep doing it.
You know? And then Siobhan, our guy, come and carry me. You know you're the cool guy. You're the coolest of them all. Well, time for us to wrap it up, shall we?
Yes, we should.
Well, Kabs, this has been a fantastic show.
Absolutely. And speaking of TV.
Yes.
Live on the Red Carpet TV show is making 1 year in existence.
Congratulations.
Showing in Nigeria, Rwanda, and Uganda.
Woo! Africa is watching.
Africa is totally
Congratulations
watching.
To Live on the Red Carpet,
Live
doing a great job.
Africa, we have tried to really transform the Red Carpet.
Well, speaking of that, I also want to wish my mom, it's her birthday today. So happy birthday, mommy. I hope you have a fantastic day.
Yes,
now, we want to celebrate this and pop a little bit of champagne.
A little bit of champagne.
Pop, pop, pop.
To all my producers.
Let's do this.
Live on the red carpet. Shadrach, Andrew, these guys make the show happen, you know?
Mm.
Yes, so it should be me serving you.
You were talking too much, Zenjaga. You're making too much. You're talking too much. Let's do this. Some bubbly, bubbly, bubbly.
Yes.
Mm.
And not forgetting the producers of the camera.
Notice I have more.
Not forgetting the camera people of this show. Yes. We have,
guys, we want to say a big thank you to Dixon, to Billy, to Frank. Thank you so much for everything.
You make this show happen.
And Abdul as well. Salute to everybody. And you, the viewers, the loop. Mm.
And to Bush Baby.
Remember, Nyumbani Decor right here. Industrial areas, First Street, plot number 7. A big thank you to you. And a big thank you to Sonia, who's responsible for my hair. Okay. Remember, The Loop, Sunday, 8:30 p.m. every Sunday. And a repeat on
Monday at 11:30 a.m.
Well done. We'll catch you guys next time.